one of them, Carl Benjamin, is number 458, the Spirit of God, 458.
For Jesus, you came to gather the nations into the peace of God's kingdom. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
For Jesus, you came in word and sacrament to strengthen us in holiness. Christ, have mercy. For Jesus, you will come in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us one day to everlasting life.
Amen.
There is mass intentions for Muriel Liturgian, for successful surgery, Leonida Mendoza Vicencio, eternal grace. Let us pray. O God, who care for your people with gentleness and rule them in love, through the intercession of Pope St. Gregory, and though we pray with the spirit of wisdom, those to whom you have given authority to govern, that the flourishing of a holy flag may become the eternal joy of the generous. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen. A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the Spirit scrutinizes everything, even the depths of God. Among men, who knows what pertains to the man, except his spirit that is within? Similarly, no one knows what pertains to God, except the Spirit of God. We have not received the Spirit of the world, but the Spirit who is from God, so that we may understand the things freely given us by God. And we speak about them not with words taught by human wisdom, but with words taught by the Spirit, describing spiritual realities in spiritual terms. Now the natural man does not accept what pertains to the Spirit of God, for to him it is foolishness, and he cannot understand it, because it is judged spiritually. The one who is spiritual, however, can judge everything. but is not subject to judgment by anyone. For who has known the mind of the Lord so as to counsel him? But we have the mind of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our responsorial psalm, the Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
The Lord is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and of great kindness. The Lord is good to all, and compassionate toward all his works.
The Lord
is just in all his ways. Let all your works give you thanks, O Lord, and let your faithful ones bless you. Let them discourse of the glory of your kingdom and speak of your might.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
Making known to men your might and the glorious splendor of your kingdom. Your kingdom is a kingdom for all ages, and your dominion endures to all generations. The Lord is just in all his ways. The Lord is faithful in all his words, and holy in all his works. The Lord lifts up all who are fallen, and raises up all who are bowed down.
The Lord is just in all his ways.
Jesus rebuked him and said, "Be quiet, come out of him." Then the demon threw the man down in front of them and came out of him without doing him any harm. They were all amazed and said to one another, "What is there about his word? For with authority and power he commands the unclean spirits, and they come out." And news of him spread everywhere in the surrounding region. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
The power of Jesus confirms his authority of his teaching. We see that this morning when Jesus released this man of that spirit that was instructing this man, and even other people were affected by this man possessed with this spirit. So Jesus restored this possessed man to God and to himself. And this shows us that the power and the authority of Jesus when he teaches. The Gospel tells us that Jesus does not speak with words, but he takes action. And as we see this miracle, this is the first miracle that Jesus performed in the Gospel of Luke. And this first miracle tells us about the earthly mission of Jesus. So the earthly mission of Jesus is to reveal the love of God both through preaching and throughout all the countless gestures of attention and kindness to the sick, to the needy, to the possessed, to children, and also to sinners. This is how we see the earthly mission of Jesus working, specifically by doing those actions or gestures of kindness and love and compassion to those who were rejected, the children, the sinners, the poor, the possessed as well. So Jesus the Lord is our teacher, powerful in word and deed. And we will see that in all the miracles that Jesus performed in the Gospel. The Gospel shows us that Jesus the Lord is teacher in word and in deed. So as we continue our celebration, the Gospel teaches also that Jesus transmits to each one of us the necessary strength to overcome difficulties, the necessary strength to overcome trials and even temptations. So let us then consider what a great grace is that we all of us have known God, who is powerful and good. Let us entrust ourselves to this Jesus who is powerful and good. Let us entrust ourselves to Jesus who is Lord, but also a teacher and a friend, who always shows us the path that takes of each one of us when we are in need. So that teacher who is powerful and good continues to work in each one of us. Let us then be able to discover the power and the goodness of Jesus in every action or gesture of kindness, love, and compassion that God and Jesus have to each one of us. Please rise and let us present our needs and intentions before God. That the Holy Spirit may instill in all members of the Church a zeal for evangelization, so that others may come to know Jesus. Let us pray to the Lord. For the world, may good news of Jesus Christ inspire all people in working toward the fulfillment of God's kingdom on earth. Let us pray to the Lord. For all who struggle with doubt and uncertainty, may God help them carry their burdens and open their hearts to the same word. Let us pray to the Lord. for this assembly, gathered here, that God enlighten our hearts to boldly share with others the gift of faith He has given us. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us present also our deeds and intentions in the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord. For Muriel Vitorcia and Leonida Mendoza Vicentio, let us pray to the Lord. God of all creation, we ask that you hear and answer our prayers and needs according to your divine providence. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Through the fear and word of human hands, it will be God for us the bread of life.
Blessed
are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and word of human hands, it will be God our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that this sacrifice may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant our supplication, we pray, O Lord, that this sacrifice we present in celebration of Saint Gregory may be for our good, since through its offerings we have loosed the offenses of all the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit. Lift
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right
and just. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Jesus Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state. By his suffering, canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. And by ascending to you, Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your glory, and without end we acclaim. Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is the God who is in the world. Hosanna in the
highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the Father of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these things we pray by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. Let us proclaim Jesus the mystery of faith. We proclaim you dead, O Lord, and profess his resurrection unto the God. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you this morning. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Jesus, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church is spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope, Blaise our Bishop, and all your people. We pray for Muriel in Georgia for successful surgery. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Leonida Mendoza Vicencio, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Joseph, the spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Padre Pio, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us pray together as Jesus Christ. Amen. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look down on our sins, but at the faith of the people, and graciously grant them peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you all. Let us offer each other the sign. Lamb of God, to take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, to take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, to take away the sins of the world. Behold Jesus, behold me, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
Our communion is number 848 in your letter book, Pandemic. Praise my soul, the King of heaven.